فاتحة. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين، آمين. السلام عليكم my dear brothers and sisters in إيمان. الحمد لله على نعمه الكثيرة الوفيرة التي تشمل كل نواحي حياتنا، ولا نفقه ولا نفهم منها إلا اليسير. Praise be to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for all his gifts and bounties that are too many for us to comprehend or understand. All a little of that maybe we are aware of and we acknowledge if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala permits. As we were talking the week before last about the hadith that is one of the most greatest ahadith in Islam, when the man came to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and asked of him, جاء رجل إلى رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم فقال, a man came to the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم and said, إني أسألك الله عما يغنيني في الدنيا والآخرة. I ask you, O Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, by Allah, to inform me about that which will make me happy here and happy in the hereafter, to be content here and in the hereafter. فقال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, the Messenger, peace be upon him, said to him, سل عما بدا لك, ask whatever comes to your heart or mind. فقال الرجل, the man then says, يا نبي الله, O Prophet of Allah, أحب أن أكون أعلم الناس, I want to be the most learned of people. And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said to him, اتق الله تكون أعلم الناس, fear Allah, you'll be the most learned. And we spoke about that. Then he said, أحب أن أكون أغنى الناس, I would love to be the richest of mankind. قال عليه الصلاة والسلام, كن قانعا تكون أغنى الناس, be content, you will be the richest of people. And we spoke about that. For indeed, the Prophet said in the hadith, to be rich is not through currency or money or gold and silver, but to be content with what Allah has given to you. And the third one we talked about, he said, أُحِبُّ أَنْ أَكُونَ خَيْرَ النَّاسِ, I would love to be the best of people. And the Prophet ﷺ said to him, خَيْرُ النَّاسِ مَنْ يَنْفَعُ النَّاسِ, the best of people is the one who is always of benefit to others, the one who serves others. Today we'll speak about the next three. Number four, the man says, أُحِبُّ أَنْ أَكُونَ أَعْدَلَ النَّاسِ, I would love to be the most just among people. قال عليه السلام, the Messenger, peace be upon him, says, أحب للناس ما تحب لنفسك, تكن أعدل الناس. أحب للناس, love for people what you love for yourself, you will be the most just person. Now, there is a hadith of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم relating to Iman. Iman is a wide, spacious space for a journey to Allah through different stages. Rasulullah SAW said in the hadith, Al-Imanu bid'un wa sab'una daraja. The Messenger, peace be upon him, says, Iman is 70 odd stages, ranks. Could be 71, 73, 75, 77, or 79. أدناها إماط الأذى عن الطريق. The lowest is when you have a conscience. When you are in the street, in public places, and you see any harmful object that could harm anyone or anything, and your conscience will not allow you to pass it by, and you pick it up and remove it. This will enter into this hadith. أحب للناس, love for people. The person who does that, he loves for people because he has iman, although it is very low. But then he says, وأعلاها, and the highest peak of iman, التقوى, piety, to fear none but Allah, to seek from none but Allah, to turn to none but Allah, to depend upon none but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Everything in your life is connected only to Him. So the base is to have a conscious whereby you feel the feeling of others. You worry for others. You don't want anyone or anything to be harmed. But you wish them as you wish for yourself. And the peak on the top of this high pyramid is that you are conscious of Allah at all time, fearful that He will see you where He does not want you to be, or He misses you where you should be doing what He has asked of you. So here, this iman, the Prophet also described it as a light in the heart. He said, al-iman nur. He said, iman is a light. Allah puts it into the heart of the human being. So some people, their light increases. Some people, their light decreases. He said, al-iman kan nur. Ya'lu wa yahbit. Iman is like a light. It goes up and it comes down. I always remind myself and others, imagine like a dim light. The lower you dim it, the harder you could see. The higher you put it on, the clearer you see. So in order for us to link what the Prophet says here, if you want to be just, or the best of people who are in justice, seem to be number one, you need to love for people. The hadith of iman in this, قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, لا يؤمن أحدكم, لا يؤمن. One of you can never claim to be a believer حتى يحب لأخيه ما يحب لنفسه. Until you love for your brother or sister what you love for yourself. So already the Prophet taught us iman is linked to your loving to others rather than wanting them troubles or difficulties or destruction. We don't do that. A believer doesn't pray against others if they believe. And that is something very important. And even if they don't believe, you pray for guidance. For it is He who gave us the example at the time when He entered Mecca and the mushrikeen came to Him. Rather than taking them to prison and punish them, He said, اذهبوا فأنتم الطلقاء. Go, for you are free. I'm not going to question you. The man then asked the Prophet ﷺ, number five, and said, أُحِبُّ أَنْ أَكُونَ أَخَصْ النَّاسِ. أُحِبُّ أَنْ أَكُونَ أَخَصْ النَّاسِ. I would love to be the most preferred servant to Allah. Somebody whom Allah select for Himself. Allah will prefer for Himself. Allah will bring nearest to Him. Like Ibrahim alayhi salam, Khalilur Rahman. Like Musa alayhi salam, Kalimullah. Like Isa alayhi salam, Ruhullah. Like Muhammad sallallahu alayhi salam, Habibullah. So this man asked something special. قال عليه السلام, the messenger peace be upon him said to him, أكثر ذكر الله تكون أخص الناس. Increase your remembrance of Allah, you will be the most deserved to be closest to Allah. The Prophet is speaking Quran here. For the Quran said, أذكروني أذكركم. Do remember me, then I will remember you. Hence, if you don't remember Allah, Allah will not remember you. But once you remember Him, He will remember you. And He says, if you remember me within yourself, I will remember me you within myself. So if you remember Allah within yourself alone, Allah will remember you within Himself. ومن ذكرني في ملأ ومن ذكرني في ملأ. And whosoever remember me in a congregation, I will remember him in a better congregation. ذكرته في ملأ خير منه. I will definitely remember you, my servant. Once you remember me in a congregation that's better than your congregation. Of course, the congregation of Allah is better. With the highest of the creation that he created among the angels and other creatures, we don't know. We only know what he had informed us. So here, you want to be akhas an-nas, you want to be the most preferred, the favorite, close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Keep your tongue always busy with the mention of Allah. Be mindful of Allah. Remove any ill feeling towards anyone or anything from your heart. And remove yourself from all bad thoughts. For indeed, some of your thoughts could be sins that create a camouflage so that you will not be able to understand and see. And the final one, number six for today, the man says, أُحِبُّ أَنْ أَكُونَ مِنَ الْمُحْسِنِينَ أُحِبُّ أَنْ أَكُونَ مِنَ, I would love to be among the muhsins. And we know al-ihsan is the highest station a Muslim who submitted and strived in doing that which Allah has commanded by accomplishing and fulfilling the requirement of doing what he has asked of us to do in good and refraining from that which is bad, which is haram and forbidden. Subhanallah, you reach that maqam, maqam al-ihsan. As when Jibreel alayhi salam walked into the majlis in the midday sun, dressed in brilliant white clothes, and sat opposite the Prophet, his knees touching the knees of Rasulullah sallam, and he was putting his hand on his thighs like the Prophet was doing. And he asked him, Mal Islam? What is Islam? Mal Iman? What is Iman? Mal Ihsan? The Prophet then answered this man, because he asked to be from the Muhsinin. He said to him, قال عليه السلام أعبد الله كأنك تراه فإن لم تكن تراه فإنه يراك. Worship Allah, watching him. He is with you, seeing you, what you are doing. Like a child sitting in front of his teacher or his parents. He will not dare to do anything wrong. But he will do as he has been commanded, and he will do that which will please. You want to be a muhsin? Always be conscious of Allah being with you. As he says in the Quran, وَهُوَ مَعَكُمْ أَيْنَمَا كُنْتُمْ. And it is he, Allah, with you wherever you might be. Hearing everything we say, seeing everything we do. لَا تَخْفَى عَلَيْهِ خَافِيَ. Allah, nothing is hidden from him. Allah is the Almighty. Allah is the one who created us out of his love and given us out of love his beautiful words, the Holy Quran, and his beloved Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We should be thankful. We should indeed be grateful. And we should strive to be among the muhsinin. Why? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, indeed Allah loves the muhsins. Each one of us would love to hear Allah saying, my servants, I do love you. I do love you. This is what the righteous men and women and the greatest of the sages and the companions and the prophets and the messengers and Sayyidina Muhammad sallam yearned for. To hear the speech of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To listen to his words. Because once you hear Allah, nothing else is important. Once you see Allah, nothing else is important. Because there is nothing but him. Alayhi subhanahu wa ta'ala. Kul التسبيحات والتحميدات. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allow us to be continuously remembering him subhanahu wa ta'ala and acknowledging all the favor that he has bestowed upon us. I ask Allah for everybody listening that Allah will make their life easy. Allah will give them tawfiq and success for dunya wal akhirah. And these beautiful days of Rajab, let us work harder in them. Those who can fast, please fast. Yani, some of the other Mondays, Thursdays, or fast the three middle days, the Amanur, 13, 14, and 15. And even if you can't fast any, at least the day of the 27th of Rajab, it's the day after the night of Mi'raj, whereby Rasulullah was being gifted the greatest of gifts to be taken to meet his Lord and to receive the best of gifts from him, a salah that we pray every day, five times a day. So may Allah give me and you whatever we require and need to accomplish this in this month, inshallah. Mustafa, assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum salam, Sheikh. How are you?
How are you, Sidi? Are you all right?
Alhamdulillah, shukrullah. Alhamdulillah.
Family as well?
Alhamdulillah. Sheikh, my brother was mentioning to me yesterday that you remember Mabruk, who used to come to our circle, his mother passed away.
I will ring him. Allah, I will ring him, Mabruk. He's a good friend of ours for years. I know the man. Attend the circle regularly. May Allah bless him, guard him, and give him tawfiq for the dunya wal akhirah, inshallah. We pray for him at the end. Akif, assalamu alaikum. How are you, Sidi?
I'm very well, thank you. May I ask a quick question?
Yes.
My father asked me to ask you, actually. He was reading the Quran and he was a little bit confused at one point in the mention of Ibrahim alayhi salam and his father. And it mentions that his father was an idolater or made the idols. Is that a reference to his biological father or his adoptive father, who's his uncle? It is
in the tafsir, there are two explanations. Some people, they will say his father, okay, because he call him, because in Arabic, your uncle is your father. And I call my uncle Abuy, and I call my father Abuy. Okay. Yeah. Lakin when I come to my uncle to distinguish, for example, my father is Ahmad, I will never call him by his name Ahmad. But if it's my uncle is Muhammad or Ali, I say Abuy Muhammad, Abuy Ali. Mm-hmm. He's my father, but to distinguish him as my father's brother. Okay? Mm-hmm. Okay. So here, the Quran is mentioning Ibrahim alayhi salam asking Allah to salvage his father, from the hellfire. And they say it is his father who used to be the leading man in the making and manufacturing of the idols in the place where they used to live. But in some tafsir, they say it is his uncle. Not his biological father, but his father's brother. It doesn't matter whether it's his father or it's his mother. But the resemblance of the life of the Prophet and Ibrahim alayhi salam is almost similar. That's why they are of the five greatest messengers. Sayyidina Muhammad sallam, Sayyidina Isa, Sayyidina Musa, Sayyidina Nuh, and Sayyidina Ibrahim. Because all of them, they were fighting people who were into shirk. Taking idols. Musa alayhi salam, his people were in Egypt. And look at them, they came after all this trouble, they wanted to be saved, and they were worshiping the calf. Okay, made of gold. Nuh alayhi salam, he was praying to Allah to destroy all the mushrikeen from the earth and to save only those who believe in him, and Allah did that and saved them in the ark. Okay? Sayyidina Muhammad sallam, look at his family, his uncles. They were all into, few of them, of course, they became Muslim later on. And when you look at Sayyidina Ibrahim, it's the same. So it is, in terms of seer, his father, in terms of seer, it is his uncle, inshallah. Yusha, assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum salam, Sheikh.
How are you, my brother? Are you all right?
Yes, alhamdulillah. But my brother's dear friend, her husband, died of cancer today.
Allahu Akbar. Who died?
My brother, his friend, this girl, from they were young, she got married, and she finally got married, and they finally had a kid, the husband got cancer, man, he died today.
Rahmatullah. We'll pray for him, inshallah. May Allah give him a high place in Jannah. And may Allah give us the patience and the family too, inshallah. Jazakumullah khair. Maimoon, assalamu alaikum. Naam, Sidi Yusha. Maimoon, assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam, Shaykh. How are you
doing? Nice to see you. How are you keeping?
It's great to see you too. Alhamdulillah.
How is the family?
I'm doing good. Very good. Alhamdulillah. Yes.
May Allah bless you. Look after you.
Thank you for such a beautiful reminder. These are real gems and I'm loving it. So thank you so much.
We love to always be in the presence of people like yourself so that we can remember Allah. Because Allah deserves to be remembered. And the whole idea is the reminder will benefit each one of us.
Inshallah.
Allah said in the Quran, فَذَكِّرْ and do remind. For indeed reminders are good for those who believe. فَذَكِّرْ إِنَّ الذِّكْرَ تَنْفُعُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ فَذَكِّرْ indeed, O Muhammad sallam, do remind, for your reminder will benefit those who believe. I hope inshallah to be of benefit. And especially in this kind of time where the world is in turmoil, with all the technology we have, with all the strength we have, with all, yani, the best thing that happened since this calamity has overtaken the world, there is no longer fighting and wars. They all stopped. But before that, Yemen is burning, Syria is burning, every weapon has been tried in Afghanistan, whatever, but suddenly everything has stopped. Allah is giving those poor people a rest from that bombardment.
Allah sent us all to our rooms.
Alhamdulillah.
To think about what we did.
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. We're all being imprisoned within our home. I was talking today to my neighbor, came to see me, standing far away from the door. I said to him, I retreated to my home since 15th of March, 2020. So by this next 2-3 weeks, it will be 1 year I'm sitting at home. The only time I went out is Salatul Eid al-Adha in the masjid, and then whenever they allowed us to do Jum'ah, and that's it. Yani, I go once a week. This is started maybe from August after they allowed us to go out with my wife to do the shopping on Saturday morning, early morning. And that's it, we stay at home. So Alhamdulillah, it's been beautiful. May Allah bless you and the family, inshallah. We will talk again,
inshallah. Inshallah.
Barah, assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum salam, Shaykh. How are you?
Are you all right?
Alhamdulillah.
How are your husband and the family?
Alhamdulillah wa shukrillah. I'm blessed to see you every Saturday, alhamdulillah.
May Allah bless you too and guard you and keep you and your husband and your family back in Belgium and in Morocco and in Britain, inshallah. And make dua for us, inshallah.
I will definitely. You too, inshallah. Sheikh. Thank you.
Shukran. Daniel, assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam, Sheikh. How are you, Sheikh?
How are you, young man?
Sheikh, I have a message from Asma Khan. She's just thanking you for the Jummah khutbah. Her children found it very inspiring, Sheikh.
And may Allah bless her.
Continue to pray. Inshallah.
Inshallah. May Allah give her whatever she requires and need. And may Allah allow us to always be together, inshallah, in this world and in the hereafter. Inshallah. Give them my salam and make dua, inshallah. How is Sheikh Omar doing?
Sheikh Omar, I've been finding it a bit tricky to get in touch with him, Sheikh. Sometimes he won't answer his phone, so I'm going to try again, inshallah, tonight.
Do. Keep in touch, inshallah. He's a good man. But he'd keep traveling here and he'll be visiting people to help them. And with his age, he's helping others. May Allah bless him. Alhamdulillah. Assalamu alaikum, my brother, my daughter. How are you? Bushra, how are you keeping?
Assalamu alaikum. Alhamdulillah, we're well.
Alhamdulillah.
Blessing to be in the gathering. Alhamdulillah.
Alhamdulillah. Yeah, Abu Bushra, how are you keeping?
Alhamdulillah, Sheikh. Very good to listen to you, and it's always a blessing. Always a blessing.
Wallahi, a blessing for all of us being with you. And Allah is so generous, has taken away the physical gathering, but this is even better because everybody is sitting comfortably and more people can see each other and remember Allah together, inshallah. But we hope, inshallah, soon Allah will allow us again to meet together, inshallah. And how is your wife, my brother?
She's well. She's just had to go out downstairs to talk to her mother, but she's very well.
Give her my salam, inshallah.
Inshallah.
How is her mother and father? Are they all right?
They're very good, actually, mashallah. They've had, they're doing well. For
May Allah bless them all. And bless you all, inshallah. Keep you well. I'm going to Alhamdulillah. Jazakumullah khair. We're going to say assalamu alaikum. See you next week, inshallah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Assalamu alaikum.